Okay.
What time did Antonia go out yesterday?
She left around 9.
Do you know where she went?
No. I've no idea. She was a good girl, but she didn't confide in me.
A nosy old hag like you knows everything about the people who live under her roof. Where did she go?
I think she went to a bar.
Mm-hmm.
She's been drinking quite a lot lately.
This bar have a name?
El Dorado Bar.
El Dorado Bar.
Place on North Los Angeles Street.
That's only a couple of blocks from where we found the body.
You've had a break-in?
No. That can't be true.
You're being economical with the truth, Mrs. Lepenti. What do you have to hide?
I have no idea what you are talking about.
Broken window, obviously.
So Antonia lost her keys and used an iron bar to jimmy the back window?
I heard a noise in the early hours of the morning. I thought it might be a raccoon at the milk bottles. It'd be very bad for business if this news got out. I have a reputation to protect.
Antonia and her husband were estranged?
Yes. She moved here after she separated from her husband 2 months ago.
But Antonia still wore a wedding ring?
She wore the wedding ring and a necklace. She always wore a religious necklace. That's about all of her jewelry.
Okay.
Can you describe the necklace?
An icon of Our Lady of Guadalupe. It's quite beautiful. I let Antonia hang a painting of her there on the wall.
Thanks, ma'am. You've been very helpful.
Pay a call to that husband of hers. Lock him up and throw away the key.
The hired help at the El Dorado might have seen the drop the night she died. Maybe the break.
Okay, let's go over there then. Do we have any crimes? Nope. Let's go to the El Dorado Bar.
You're behind the wheel.
Yeah, asshole.
Nosy old hag? Ah! And I thought I was coming on strong with the ex-wife line.
Sometimes you have to be firm to get the information you need.
God damn it, ain't that the truth.
You don't think it's strange that all these murders are happening to girls who've been out drinking?
No. A broad drinks, she gets a bit tight, she starts mouthing off. This leads to that, and she ends up in an alleyway. Sad story, but this town's seen it play out 1,000 times.
Why don't you want to see a connection here?
Because there are perfectly good real-life suspects for every one of these murders. We don't need to go looking for the monster under the bed.
But there will be one. This is a video game, and there's gotta be a serial killer in it. I'm not playing like 3 murder victims in a row without a fucking serial killer.
What can I get you?
LAPD. Detectives Phelps and Galloway.
Diego Aguilar. How can I help?
You worked the bar last night?
Yeah. Me and a temp guy from the agency.
Did you have a woman in here last night? 21 years old, Hispanic, drinking heavily?
We have a lot of ladies like that in here. But yeah, I know who you mean. Antonia Maldonado. Or what did she do?
She was murdered last night.
Oh, shit.
Do you know her well? Was she a regular?
Hell no. She was good and tight last night, complaining about her old man. It's a story you get used to working in a bar. She was so hammered last night, she left a letter on the bar. I'll show you.
Okay.
Divorce papers? Did you open them?
No need to. She was shouting about it, waving the letter around, said she was gonna show him.
Okay. Put that shit back in there.
Can you remember what jewelry she was wearing?
She had a necklace. Some kind of religious thing, I think. The temp guy would have more of an idea. She took the beer he served her and cried into it all night.
What time did she leave?
Can't say for sure.
Where did she go? Give me something or the LAPD will start getting interested in this place.
Take it easy. She wanted a cab, okay? And my phone was out of order. The closest one I knew was at the fruit market across the street, so I suggested she try there. She seemed reluctant.
Did Antonia say where she was going when she left?
She said she was gonna serve the papers on the husband. Said that would take the smile off his face. If you ask me, she was scared. And the drink was for Dutch courage.